To when I was getting paid and getting laid all at the same time, hitting next on the boombox in every car stereo. Cause you see, children, Cowman was once an amateur porn star, or as my clients used to call me, the pizza guy. I used to deliver for Freddy's Pizza back in my teens. And I used to bring a VHS camera with me just in case I banged on one of my deliveries. It may have only worked like 10% of the time, but you only need 10. My long list includes that of, old Lady Birdman, who many said could never be tamed, and yet I tamed her within seconds. Which is how long the sex actually lasted, let me tell you. She may have been 90. But she could hit it like 86. She said that she was the one who invented toothpaste. And I said, maybe you should use it then, trying to kiss me on the mouth after sobbing on my knob. I don't go for that, you old bat.
Yeah, man. Didn't I tell you not to lock the basement door?
Mom, I'm doing my show, my real show, down here.
Didn't I tell you this podcast was a total waste of time? Get a real job, you loser.
Get a real job? You're talking to a man who almost toppled Illinois. I had mayors in my pocket, governors on speed dial. Now I gotta get it back.
Cowman, I need to do laundry.
Give me a minute, Ma. Just a minute.
I should have aborted you.
Oh, Jesus was aborted by his people. So do it then. Do it, you dumb bitch.
You should lock, be nicer to your mom.
And you should be a 10 out of 10 babe in a tube top with huge knockers. But you're not. So what the hell am I supposed to do? This is the Cowman's Country Slaughterhouse.
Country Slaughterhouse. Country Slaughterhouse.
Boo. A show to... Okay, listen to me right now. Close all your Pornhub tabs and turn your volume all the way up. Do it. Do it! I won't go any further until you do it. You did it. Okay. Sell all your credit. Destroy all your debit cards. And melt down all your gold. It might as well be Shanghai noon as far as China is concerned. Chinese invasion is imminent. Communism is at the door and is jerking the knob. And sure, you locked the top lock, but let me ask you this. What are you going to do with the corpse after you kill him? Bet you didn't even think about that, you stupid idiot. What was I going to say?
Something about Chinese communism?
Well, what about it, piece of poop? I'll tell you what about it. It's raising the price of my gas.
But they took away our license years ago, man.
So? I can still buy gas whenever I want, okay? I got a tub of gas at home.
We're all at your house right now, Cowman. And I didn't see nor smell no tub of gasoline. Because believe you me, pal, I'll be huffing up right
so
now.
So you really are only here just to fuck me over and correct me.
Hey, I'm just being honest, man.
And I'll be honest with you, piece of poop. I think you're treading a fine line of being gay.
Come on, what the hell?
Just testing. Did you pass? You'll never know. We'll be right back after a word from a sponsor.
I run. I hide away. I run Welcome to Olive Garden. Here's our menu and our endless spaghetti.
Yummy. Yeah. Endless, huh?
Yes, sir.
I'll tell you what's endless, pal. The pain in my cock.
In your cock, sir?
I bet I could eat all your spaghetti, but you'll never get rid of the pain in my cock. That's truly endless.
Olive Garden. Endless doesn't necessarily mean endless.
I wake up in the early mornings after nightmares, sometimes in massive cold sweats, dreaming about getting my ex-wife Barbara pregnant again. Barbara! And it makes me think. So, I went out to the street and brought back with me a feminist. What's your name again?
It's Catherine.
Okay, Kathy. You say you're a feminist, huh?
Yeah, I'm a feminist.
But you don't sound very sure to me. I thought that I was talking to a feminist warrior. Okay, I want to speak to the feminist general, okay?
I was told I'd be getting $50 for answering the questionnaire.
Yes, you're right, for answering my questions. But so far, I haven't heard any answers. But we'll see if we can get you back up on the scoreboard with this next question. Roe v. Wade, was it that big of a deal?
Of course it was. I don't have to explain why it was a huge deal.
Okay.
Women are dying because of it.
But think about it this way, sugar. Men get drafted. If you get an abortion, we're losing future soldiers. Soldiers that in the future will be wearing laser-guided helmets with jetpacks, leveling villages in Iraq. You get an abortion, and we lose future corporals. If you have an abortion, who are we gonna ship to die in Iraq? Sally gets 8 abortions, and that's a platoon gone. And not because of friendly fire. Well, at least, not in the way you think.
You could say that abortion is the friendliest of fires.
You could say that, piece of poop. You know? You think we'd have purple hearts if their moms were allowed to abort? No.
I had an abortion once. You have no idea how hard it was.
That could have been Rambo for all we know, man. And I would see that movie. Rambo 6, Mother Drew First Blood, about how his mom got an abortion.
Yeah, and I'd watch that. Who else is going to strut through the North Asian jungles shirtless and shredded, holding a machine gun, sweating with the shirt off? Awesome. Yeah, who's going to do it now?
But when he used the bow and arrow, I thought that was pretty sissy of him.
That was a grenade bow, and you know it. You son of a bitch.
Okay, fine, I get it.
So you agree with me, huh? You're a murderer, and I salute our fallen soldiers from the womb. We'll be back after a word from a sponsor. Consider yourself owned.
We know you love COD. We know you love being a sniper. We know you love being a technician. We know you love COD so much that you really think that's how it works. A bullet to the spine, you never walk again. That's how war really works. Your wife cheats on you and has a kid. Well, you're gone and says it's yours, but it doesn't look like you. There's no way Call of Duty can simulate that kind of action. GoArmy.com.
Voting. People have been doing it, despite my best protest. I mean, what's my vote gonna do, huh? Jack. But say I buy a coffee for the right guy who's been whispering in the right ear hole. I can then have my property evaluated at 12.6% higher than it should be. Yeah, just as a courtesy. Now some say that's bribery. I say you're thinking too much about it. It's just a thing that a friend would do for a friend. Now, that's how I see politics. But some people out there have been voting their asses off, and look at what they've done. They've gotten rid of our conversion therapy camps. And it's never coming back. Now, I have a gay cousin. Excuse me. I have a gay cousin, I'm pretty sure. So don't come at me, okay? I'm sure he'd enjoy going to a fun camp. He'll have a fun little weekend, a camping trip, away from his nagging bitch of a husband, where he can basketball, he can go rowing, fishing, make some s'mores, sing some campfire songs, and at the end of the day, he gets to sit in front of a computer and watch a nice man in a suit convince him of the joys of the hetero way of life. He gets to do that. And the electric shocks are there not only to keep your eyes open and make sure you know when you got the answer wrong, but it's also the price you pay for s'mores in a good old camping time. Now, I remember when I used to camp, the inevitable always happened. Look, I love s'mores. I love them so much I go online and purchase videos of s'mores.
Oh yeah, I love doing that. I even Google image s'mores, sir.
Yes, I see you really just Google s'mores. Yeah,
they're delicious.
Well, yeah, that's exactly what I'm talking about.
Yum, yum.
And nothing else. What's this? I'm getting a call from Tom Cruise. Hey, Tommy, you're live on the show.
Hello. Hello, Cowman? Hey. I was just listening and I wanted to clarify for the audience what you meant by s'mores.
Oh, whatever. Tom, thanks, but you don't have to do that.
Well, it'd be my honor. In the words of Xenu, you must define everything. 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 No gray areas. Tom Cruise is not gray, and neither is his hairline. It's called smoky and seasoned on the bottle. I mean, can an old guy stand on top of a plane while it's doing a 180?
Oh, Tom.
S'mores is when you get four men of different specific ethnicities. By that I mean one white guy, one black guy, and two Latin descent guys. And the Latin descent individuals play the role of the graham crackers on both ends, with the black and the white guy being interchangeable, although in experience, preferable in the order I said. Those four men then proceed to enter each other in that order, and when they all come together...
Yeah, Tom, you know, you don't have to keep going on.
They yell, "Marshmallow!" And that's how you know you made it s'more. Anyways, I've got to go save the world in the name of Elrond. Salute!
That's a s'more. I didn't want to be the one to say it, and I had no choice in the matter.
Your guy's s'mores are pretty messed up. I guess that's one of those U.S. to Canada kind of differences, huh?
Yeah. Well, at least I didn't need a horse. What happened to Seabiscuit? Did you have him with some gravy? You. We'll be right back after a word from a sponsor.
Wanted. If you see this man, call the authorities immediately. We will shoot on sight. Santa is most definitely very much real, and he could be threatening your child's life this Christmas.
Shh. Welcome. Were you followed? Come inside and make yourself a home. I just bought a new roll of, one sec. Alright, here. Put this on while we dive deep into the weeds of so-called truths. Now, I avoid Taylor Swift drama, okay? You could say I do it swiftly. Yeah, whenever that comes along. But this one's big. Huge. Alright, take a look at this photograph obtained through illegal means. If this does not look like subliminal messaging, then I would ask you if you know what subliminal messaging means. And then, I would ask you if you would believe me if I told you that the NFL writes their own scripts. And then, I would ask you if you believe me if I told you that it wasn't just good old Goodell typing away, writing up those specs. No. You would never believe me if I said that. And you'll definitely deny this next truth, because I'm Jiminy Cricket and you're just trying to be a real boy out there, but you're going about it all the wrong ways. You see, when you look up at the night sky, Nice guy to big starry lights and think that's amore? Well, really, that's aliens. Right? Writing up those twisted outcomes and developments on Sunday night. Alright? T-Swift and T-Kelce? Weird? Huh? I don't know. But this photo does. Now tell me. What's up with that? Huh? No way does this just happen. Look, I played enough NFL Madden Manager to know that I can completely destroy or create any star that I want. And I think that the aliens know this as well. Because when you've got a blaster pointed at your urethra, you'll do anything. And you'll get into any relationship. You'll say anything. Alright? You know, how that ancient aliens guy still has a penis by now? Or, you know, well, hasn't had disgusting alien babies? It's just beyond me.
I peed next to that guy at a urinal at a hot rock convention.
That's risky.
Yeah, well, let's just say he's huge. You know, down there. So, maybe the aliens gave him some kind of off-world steroid, or maybe. Just maybe.
Listen, piece of poop, don't finish that thought. Are you saying alien Viagra?
Oh,
because that's dangerous. Alright, we'll be right back after a word from a sponsor.
It's one small step for man, one giant.
Come again?
Houston, we have a moon pie.
We're in a race against the Russians. Have you planted the flag? Over.
Houston, they already landed a monkey with two flags and a machine gun. I told them, I said, leave me to my moon pies, monkey. So, we're waiting till the monkey falls asleep before we kill it and plant the stars and stripes. In the meantime, moon pie out.
That last ad was directed by the very much dead Stanley Kubrick.
Final thoughts on this edition of the Cowman's Country Slaughterhouse. You probably won't be surprised to know that Joe Rogan thinks that immigrants are being brought into Chicago in the back of tent-covered trucks, given clothes, food, money, and a cell phone, then sent out into the night, never to be seen again. That is, until they're mowing your lawn one morning and you're like, uh-oh. But you know what I gotta say, Joe? You're right about this one, Baldy. And as an agent of chaos myself, I too would totally bring up a bunch of illegal immigrants into a city where they can't vote to have them vote a lot.
How do you do that, Connor?
Well, it's easy. Piece of poop. Simple, really, okay? Every time that somebody dies, guess what, Jesus? You get to be Chester Scott from 2125 10th Street, Chicago. Enjoy your new life, amigo. That's how. And now that Joe Biden's still president, and Chicago's crime rate is as high as ever, but especially higher than New York's, I can't even walk down the street without getting violated by taco trucks, barbershops, and illegal immigrants of my own design that are shaking me down and robbing my banks. You'd think this would be great as an insurance scam, but no! Those baldies won't even take my calls. Ever since I tried to claim elk violence on my, at the time, brand new Trans Am, my brother, who I love, but gets all the way up in my biz sometimes, took a set of elk antlers and rammed them into my windshield. Prior to him doing that, I thought, yeah, this is a great idea to upgrade to a Chevy Bel Air. But no. No, there was no blood on the car. I told him we needed to get some pig blood or something and splash it all over. Yeah, so in other words, I think Joe as in Rogan, was definitely onto something when he said that illegals are going to vote us out. And that's why I say we reverse psychology here, huh? And we vote them into power. And then they can see how hard it is for us, right? Right? Foolproof plan, no drawbacks. This has been the Cowman's Country Slaughterhouse. Where I'm saying, don't just vote twice. Vote three or four times. Alright. Chill out, Chicago. Move!